Welcome to our channel. In this video, we are going to talk about best hidden gems in London you should visit before it gets crowded. So before starting, please like this video, and subscribe to our channel for future updates. Although all of the obvious attractions are a must-see, some of London's more fascinating treasures are less well-known than you may think. There are so many hidden beauties in London that, to be honest, you aren't doing the city credit if you don't take the time to explore it. As a tourist, it's all too easy to tick off a list of the major sights and declare that you've seen London. Even if you live in the area, you know how easy it is to get stuck in a rut doing the same old things. But make no mistake, if you're not uncovering hidden gems in London, you're only getting half the tale. Who wouldn't be interested in discovering an old Roman temple buried deep within the city? Or how about visiting one of South London's highest locations, where you can take in some of the city's best vistas, in complete peace? How about a trip to a historic manor house's secret garden inn? It's all well and good for me to espouse the merits of exploring London's lesser-known areas, but who has the time to undertake all that research? To sift through the chaff to find the truly worthwhile material? 1. St. Dunstan's in the East. The original church was tragically destroyed by the Great Fire of London. It was badly rebuilt, had to be knocked down and rebuilt, only to be bombed to bits during the Blitz. The authorities gave up at this point and transformed St. Dunstan's as the city's most peculiar park. And that's why, in the heart of London City, you can now have lunch in the open-air ruins of a medieval cathedral. It is one of London's best-kept secrets, as well as a fantastic site for photography and cinematography among the present secret keepers. 2. The smallest police station in the UK. If you've ever visited Trafalgar Square, you've probably walked right past this without recognizing it. The smallest police station in the United Kingdom is a true hidden treasure in the heart of London. Locals wanted it to remain hidden, therefore it was installed within an attractive light fitting in 1926. It only had enough room for one or two police officers at a time to keep a watch on the square for additional boisterous protesters. In case backup was needed, a direct phone connection to Scotland Yard was built. The little police station is now only a storage area for the municipal council cleaners' materials. 3. Pickering Place. A hidden gem around the corner from St. James's Palace is one you'll only find if you're in the know. Pickering Place may be the tiniest square in the United Kingdom, but that doesn't mean it's devoid of history. Because of its hidden location, this tiny courtyard was formerly home to gambling houses, bear baiting, and even duels. It was the site of London's very last duel, in the 18th century. You can see all the vestiges of the Georgian era, from the gaslights to the gorgeous architecture, if you visit now. Pickering Place was the location of the Texan Republic's embassy before the country became a part of the United States in 1845, before it became a noted hotspot for criminal activities. You'll find a plaque commemorating its presence at the time, which means it's well over 150 years old. 3. The Seven Noses. There are seven noses sculpted by artist Rick Buckley strewn across Soho, which should make for an interesting sight, and an impressive treasure hunt list for visitors to London. In 1997, artist Rick Buckley staged a protest against the installation of CCTV cameras in London streets. Many people were starting to see these surveillance cameras as a significant step closer to a Big Brother state, which drew a lot of criticism. Whereas the less artistic among us would choose to protest by committing acts of willful damage, Rick Buckley chose a far more subtle and, dare I say, amusing way. The notion of the Seven Noses of Soho was conceived as a result of this. Inspired by the Situationists, a group of artists and writers who engaged in sporadic, illegal acts, Rick decided to put his nose to the grindstone and began placing plaster of Paris and polymer casts of his nose on various structures throughout London, right under the noses of the liberty-threatening CCTV cameras. 4. Strand Station. This station, also known as Aldwych Station, is no longer in operation but is an important part of London's history. For example, it was used to secure artwork from museums in London during the war, and is now closed. Aldwych is a London underground station in the city of Westminster in central London that is currently closed. It opened in 1907 and was the terminal of the short Piccadilly line branch from Holborn that was a vestige of the amalgamation of two railway systems. The station is located at Aldwych, near the Strand's intersection with Surrey Street. Several unrealized expansion ideas for the branch were made during its history, with the tunnels through the station being extended southwards, generally to Waterloo. The station and branch were considered for closure multiple times due to low passenger counts and the use of a shuttle train. From 1962 to 1994, service was only available during weekday peak hours, when the expense of upgrading the elevators was deemed too exorbitant for the revenue earned. 5. St. Martin's Window. There are numerous reasons to visit St. Martin in the Fields, particularly the free afternoon concerts, but while you're there, keep an eye out for St. Martin's Window, a one-of-a-kind window inside an already magnificent structure. In 2008, Shereza Houshieri collaborated with architect Pip Horn to create a new east window that was put above the altar of St. Martin in the Fields. The commission marked the completion of Eric Perry Architects' renewal project for the church. The bold design by Houshieri and Horn brings light into the Grade 1 listed church and is one of the most important works of religious art commissioned in recent years. The glass is comprised of mouth-blown clear glass panels engraved on both sides with a delicate, feathery pattern, a distinguishing feature of Houshieri's paintings, and is held within a stainless steel framework. The glass panels progress from a more transparent periphery to a denser, wider center. The center ellipse is softly carved and illuminated to provide a focal point of light that can be seen both interior and externally. 6. The Whitechapel Bell Foundry. To cut a long tale short, this is the same business that produced Big Ben and the Liberty Bell in the United States, shown above, both of which are iconic symbols of American independence. The most astounding aspect is that it is the UK's oldest manufacturing company, having been in operation for nearly 500 years, and you can also buy a bell here, which is sure to be one of the most exciting, historic mementos you can obtain in London. The Whitechapel Bell Foundry was a company based in Tower Hamlets, London. It was the oldest manufacturing enterprise in the United Kingdom at the time of its closure in Whitechapel. The Bell Foundry specialized in church bells, fittings, and accessories, as well as single tolling bells, carillon bells, and hand bells. The foundry was known for producing the Liberty Bell, a famous emblem of American independence, as well as recasting Big Ben, the bell that chimes from the Houses of Parliament's North Clock Tower, the Elizabeth Tower. The Whitechapel premises are a Grade 2 listed building. The foundry closed on the 12th of June 2017, after nearly 450 years of bell making and 250 years at its Whitechapel site, with the final bell cast given to the Museum of London along with other artifacts used in the manufacturing process, and the building has been sold. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go and also press the bell icon so that you can get notification about our new videos. If it was helpful, then share it with others. Thanks for watching the video.